What do we have in common with the Hulk when we are stuck in traffic on a Monday morning? Well, we don't become green or strong, but there's one emotion that erupts in all of us, anger. If you feel something like this on your bad days, you've come to just the right place. But hold on, angry Hulk also turns back into peace-loving Bruce Banner. Then how can all of us control our anger? In this video, I'm going to give you the science of anger and what causes it. I'm also going to give you 6 tried and tested methods to manage your anger. And finally, 2 bonus tips right at the end. So let's get going and make sure you watch right till the end and leave me a comment below or I will become like an angry Hulk. Hey, this is Chetna and you're watching ChetChat. Let's begin by talking about the science behind anger. When there is a mismatch between what you expect and what you get in turn, maybe you get bad marks when you thought you did well, your brain's reward circuit sounds an alarm. Activity is triggered in a small almond-shaped region in the brain called the amygdala, which processes emotions of anxiety, fear, and anger. Fear and anger generate a basic stress response called flight or fight, where fear makes us want to flee and anger makes us want to fight. This amygdala sends a distress signal to the hypothalamus, which is the command center of the body's nervous system. The hypothalamus in turn signals the adrenal glands, which sit on top of the kidney, to release hormones like adrenaline, epinephrine, and norepinephrine. This cocktail of hormones increases our heartbeat, breathing, and pushes more blood to the face and floods the muscles with glucose, preparing us for action. But whether we actually end up punching someone depends on another part of the brain, the prefrontal cortex. This is responsible for decision-making and reasoning. And this is where emotions are being processed in a more logical manner. So if someone points a finger at us wrongly, or if someone tries to take advantage of our vulnerability, we lash out at them. Many times, we are going through a mix of emotions, like guilt or sorrow, and we deflect these with anger. Now, comment below and share with me what makes you angry. Now, does anger solve your problems? So if anger is a natural emotion, why is it so bad? According to the American Psychology Association, anger is a natural adaptive response to threats. But as Plato has said very wisely, there are 2 things a person cannot be angry at: what you can control and what you cannot control. And on that note, let's talk about our tried and tested techniques to deal with anger. And in case you're looking for techniques to deal with failure and stress, then this video is going to help you. How to control anger, technique number 1. Let off steam, gently. Just like any other emotion, anger needs to be expressed. But there's a right way of doing it. Don't shout or throw a tantrum. Have a conversation with your friends or your parents about why you're feeling angry. This will make you feel lighter. Now, before we continue with our list of techniques, I want to give a shout out to Ketaki Karnik, whose lovely message got 86 likes from you. And if you want a shout out in my next video, then leave me a comment below with the hashtag ChetChatters. Technique number 2, don't let the bottle pop. Author Mark Twain said, anger is an acid that can do more harm to the vessel in which it is stored than the vessel in which it is poured. Let's do a thought experiment to prove this. Pick up a glass of water right now and imagine you're holding a glass of water in your outstretched hand. This glass weighs no more than 100 or 200 grams. It's not heavy. You can hold it for 5 minutes. The problem? No problem. You can hold it for 15 minutes. You start feeling a stretch in your arm. Half an hour, your arm is really starting to hurt now. 1 hour, your arm is throbbing, you can't hold it anymore. You let your arm down and the glass shatters. But how do we prevent this shattering or burning? Let me give you a story, which is technique number 3, a homemade antidote to anger. Once upon a time, a woman came to witty Birbal with a problem. "My husband is very angry and always angry. Whenever he opens his mouth to speak, he starts fighting. please give him a medicine. Birbal was stumped, but he gathered his wits and procured a small bottle for the lady. "This is a very special medicine," he said. "If anyone angers your husband or he feels like fighting, tell him to drink this and count to 10. All the anger will immediately disappear." The woman left pleased, and Birbal soon forgot about the matter. A few weeks later, this woman came back more devastated than before. "The medicine was working wonders," she told Birbal, "but now it's over. Please give me some more." Hearing this, Birbal started laughing. The woman was confused. "Do you know what that medicine is?" he asked her. "No," she replied. "That medicine is nothing other than water," Birbal revealed. "The trick is not in the medicine, but in what it does. Since your husband's mouth is full, he cannot shout. And since I told him to count from 1 to 10, his mind used that time to calm itself down. And now he's no longer angry." Mind you, there's a science behind Birbal's simple trick of counting from 1 to 10. In this extra time, our bodies do not react according to our amygdala's fight response, but allow for the logical response of the prefrontal cortex to kick in, which takes about a few seconds longer to activate. So don't forget to leave me a comment below on what techniques, by the way, you use to effectively control your anger. Technique number 4, LOL. No, really, laugh out loud. Another great way to control your anger is to laugh it away. Try to find the humor in the situation by using funny Snapchat filters or crack jokes with your friends. After all, laughter releases endorphins that produce a feel-good effect on your mind and body. Technique number 5, substitute to end dispute. The substitution method is a Buddhist practice that encourages us to focus on the positive aspects of a person or situation instead of the negative. Now, let's say you're angry at the words of your brother. How about you appreciate the helpful actions or motivating thoughts that he otherwise shares with you? This will increase empathy and decrease anger. At number 6 is channel your anger. One thing about anger is that it fills you up with a lot of energy. My last tip in controlling anger is making the best use of this creative energy, a bit like Lord Shiva's Tandav dance. If you're angry because you fought with your boyfriend, then go out for that long overdue run in the fresh air. Use your anger energy for some self-care. And finally, for the 2 bonus tips. Bonus tip number 1 is mindful meditation, kindful disposition. Buddha was asked, "What have you gained from meditation?" He answered, "Nothing, but I have lost anger, anxiety, depression, and insecurity." This is because over time, meditation decreases the size of the amygdala, which processes anger, and it enlarges the prefrontal cortex, which helps rational thinking. Another practice that Buddhists follow alongside meditation is loving kindness. When we wish kindly upon ourselves and others, "May you be happy, may I be healthy," our mind is filled with love and positivity, leaving no space for anger. Bonus tip number 2, whatever the question, art is a great answer. Painting a picture, writing a poem, or even playing your guitar will give you just the outlet to process and overcome your feelings. So stay happy, spread kindness, and keep smiling. And happy learning.